Yeah, what we were discussing yesterday, one of the HA options, right? How you can control the availability. VMware HA. Admission control policies. That is what we are discussing, right? Let me power on the lab. Okay, it's terminated. Fine. So the lab is already powered on. So what we are discussing, go to HA, admission control policy. Post failure cluster tolerance, we already discussed, right? So another scenario, what is the other scenario that I have gave you yesterday? Imagine you have one host with 1 TB, another host with 2 TB, and few other hosts with 1 TB RAM. Then the first option, what we are discussing, which one? This one, right? Host failure cluster tolerates. This option will not work efficiently. Okay, for that, what you have to do, let's say this cluster has 4 TB, okay, 4 TB RAM, and n minus 1. What is host failure cluster tolerance equal to 1, right? So n minus 1 means 3 minus 1, 2 host capacity. Which 2 host capacity you'll give it to the customer? Confusion, right? These two will go to customer. This host capacity will be in reserve. You're saying this, or these two will be on a customer front, and this host capacity will be in reserve. How it works, right? You'll not be able to calculate. You'll not be able to cal system will not be able to calculate host failure cluster tolerance equal to 1, even though if you give, if it is calculated. And if the bigger host goes down, what happens? What happens? Half of the VMs will be offline for some time because you don't have a space. If a bigger host goes down, you need 1 TB space here, 1 TB space here. And what you will do, existing production servers on these two systems will not work. Getting my point? Yes. So in that situation,
Hello.
what? Yeah, tell me.
So can you take average, like 1, 2, 3? You can take average and we can calculate on the basis of average.
Okay. What is the average of 4 TB? Okay.
Yeah, 1 plus 2 plus 1, 4/3.
Okay, how much? 1.3.
Means 1.33
1.3 TB is the each host capacity. Okay, fine.
average.
Now, one host capacity I want to keep it in the reserve. Which one host I will pick? 1 TB I'll pick. Okay, 1000 GB divided by 3 means 333 GB in reserve on each host. Agreed? One host capacity will be in reserve, right?
Yes.
So 333, 666 in production. 6 in production. 333 in reserve.
Yes.
333 in reserve. 1.6 in production. Okay. If this host is goes down, you have adequate capacity to restart, right? If this host goes down, you need around 650 GB. Combine both, you have it. If this host goes down,
Yes.
you still have 666 survived. But what happens if this host goes down? This host is on 1.6 TB in production, but you have 600 in reservation. Then what you will do? 600 GB, it will restart. Other 1 TB, what you will do? Host value cluster tolerance equal to host value cluster tolerance equal to 1, right? Now, no, I will take this as a reservation. So, okay, 2000 GB divided by 3, how much 2000 TB, sorry, 2000 GB divided
0.6,
by
0.6,
around 650,
600 MB, 600 GB,
650 GB, right? 2 TB means 650 GB. So now 650 GB you keep on reserve here, 650 GB keep on reserve here, and 650 GB keep on reserve here, and 1.3 TB you will use it in production, and 300 GB use it for production, 300 GB use it in production. Out of 1 TB, 60% is reservation, 30% per customer. Out of 1 TB, 60% is in reservation, 30% in production. Do you think feasible? Understood?
No.
So these options are really confusing. So what I've seen when in majority of the customer environments or in my past experience, I will see first option, host failure cluster tolerance. This I have seen very frequently. 99% of customer environments, you will see this. Okay. And in this situation, what you will do, boss? In this situation, what you will do, you will sit and calculate what is the total capacity. What is the total capacity? 4 TB. Okay, fine. 4 TB is my cluster capacity. Now, how many VMs are running? 50 VMs are running. Fine. Okay, let's do one thing. I will inform to customer saying, okay, 3 TB is production, 1 TB is in reservation. 1 TB is in reservation means how much capacity? Out of 4, 3 TB I gave it to customer, 1 TB for HA. That means 25% of RAM I will keep on reserve. You getting my point? Manual calculation. Hello?
Yes.
Okay. And CPU also. What? How many number of total CPUs on this host? 32 CPU. On this host, 24. On this host, 24. So combine all these things. Again, put some reservation out of it, 25%. Fine. Okay, boss, this is fine. What happens if a bigger host goes down? What happens if a bigger host goes down? Nothing will happen. Even if a bigger host goes down, you have a total 25% capacity. So while informing customer saying these are the benchmark values or these are the reservation values, you will also provide list of servers. Out of 50, you need to list down critical, non-critical. What are the critical machines we have? Because out of 50, you can define it, right? Critical machines, non-critical machines. So critical machines, I will put on first priority. high priority. And in non-critical machines, I will put few of them are in medium priority and few of them are low priority. So what happens, even if a bigger host goes down, critical VMs will be restarted first. Critical VMs will be restarted first, and then even though your critical VMs are powered on, you're left with some of the space. If you still have some reservation space, what you can do, the medium non-critical machines, you can restart. Still there is a space left, then power on the least priority or low priority machines. You're getting my point? This is only the option you have when you are dealing with mismatched configurations. Hello?
Yes.
Understood?
Yes, got it. Yeah.
So this is one way. Another way is you have a vCenter and you have a cluster. In this cluster, you have three different hosts. Sorry, I'm every time we're discussing three different hosts, not the scenario. If you have a cluster and around, let's say 30 hosts are there. 30 hosts are there. 30 hosts and around 650 odd VMs are running. Okay. Now, remember the yesterday scenario? I told you, right? You have requested vendor to send a quotation for new servers with what capacity the existing configurations. These servers were purchased in 2017. Now you are asking the same kind of machines a few more. Any configuration, in the sense, existing configuration is 1 TB, let's say, just for an example. Okay, and you ask a vendor 1 TB RAM servers. They are saying you'll get a 2 TB RAM servers with the same price. Fine. Now you purchased 4 ESXi hosts with the additional capacity that is double the size of current hardware configuration. So what you can do, you can create one more cluster and add all the four hosts, because these four are having similar hardware configuration. Okay. And can we move some of the VMs from this cluster to this cluster? Okay. You have 650, right? Let's target 150 machines to here. So this cluster will run with 150 machines. This cluster will run with 500 virtual machine. The utilization of this cluster, earlier it was 80. Now this has become 58. Feasible? And this is brand new. After migrating 150 servers, you have seen 38% of resource utilization. You're getting my point? Instead of adding the different configurations and different hardware vendor machines into one cluster and impact the high availability and other calculations, do create a separate cluster and migrate the machines. and follow the same rules and regulations what we have on the existing customers. In the sense, same shared storage, same kind of network configurations, and same kind of firewall rules and everything will be in place. Only the thing is, few VMs will be running on new hardware, and few VMs will be running on old hardware, so that your HA configurations will not impact. You can set up a new high availability rules here, and existing high availability rules here, they will run without any problem. If you are having mismatch or variable capacity servers within a cluster, this is how you can deal the situation. You understood, or any confusion or any queries on the scenario? Okay, understood. So what all the options we discussed? Host failure, cluster tolerance. Another one is define, let me type it. What are the things? First one, host failure, cluster tolerance equal to one. Second one is define percentage of CPU, 25%, and percentage of RAM, 25%. Okay, or else create new cluster for new host. This is another scenario, right? What else? The last option is define failover host. Define failover host means what? Means what? You have a cluster. Okay, take any cluster. This or this doesn't matter. You have a cluster. And how many hosts that you can have within the cluster? Bit louder, please. Your voice is not at all audible. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah?
Maximum 64.
Yeah. Now it is audible. I don't know. I mean, from where you're sitting and how you're talking. Now it is clearly audible. Fine. So maximum is 64, right? So you have a 64 host within a cluster. What you will do? You will purchase one big server. Out of 64, one host is bigger host. Okay, or normally same size, it's fine, not an issue. Okay, but what you will do, you will define that host as a failover host. Failover host means you will have a 63 host in production. You will have a 63 host in production, and a 64th host will be sitting ideal for 365 days. Not even a single virtual machine will run on that particular host. It will be in powered on state. It will send the heartbeat to the master every time, but it will not do anything. It will sit ideal and it will wait for HA to happen. HA to happen means whenever there is a failure, HA will work. When the failure happens in a whole year, it may happen or may not happen, because it's all precautionary things what we are taking, right? If there is any hardware failure, how to protect my customer? That is the aim. But with this reserved host or define a failover host, what happens? The host will sit ideal for lifetime. Ideal for lifetime. And the only work it will do is when the failure happens, when the hardware failure happened, host went offline, one of the hosts out of 63, whatever the VMs that are running on the particular host will be restarted onto this reserved host or a failover host. Till the time, the host will be empty, sitting ideal for 365 days. Do you think it is feasible? Solution? You are purchasing a brand new server, and just keeping ideal for reservation for lifetime. Do you think? And what is the feasible option? Out of all these three, what is the feasible options that you recommend to the customer? Guys, we discussed three different options, right? Which one you suggest to any customer?
Create new cluster for new host.
Cluster. Which one?
Third one.
Okay, if it is a brand new, then this option will come into picture. Just for a scenario sake, I have explained. Okay, we have only three options. Now, which option? I want to define HA and I want to define admission control policy. Okay, if I go to admission control policy, just a moment. Admission control policy, there are a few things here, right? One is host failure cluster tolerance. Another one is define host failover capacity by override the calculation 25%. That's it. Okay. That means it will not follow this option. It will follow this option. Other option is dedicated failover host. Select which host you want to keep in the reservation. Means if I say okay, this host will sit ideal for lifetime, rest of the host will be in production. Okay, when the production host goes down, all the VMs will come into this host and they will restart. Okay, that is another option. And you have slot policy. Okay, just a moment, someone is calling. Hello. Yes, who is this? I'll call you back. I'm in class. I'll call you back, okay? Yeah, I'll call you back. Bye. Sorry. Oh, yeah, what we're discussing? First option is this. Second option is define failover capacity. Third option is dedicated host. And in 6.7, we have got a new option called slot policy. In previous versions, it is not there. Okay, I still have to work upon it, how it will work. I haven't seen if the customers are using it or not, but VMware HA slots is a big concept, but you don't need to do anything with these slots. Okay, I'll explain briefly once this admission control policy is done, I'll explain. Okay, but my question is, out of three admission control policies, which one is best? This is the fourth one. Leave about the fourth one. I haven't seen in earlier customer setups, but we'll have to go through it theoretically. But out of the three which I have explained, which option is good and which one you will recommend? If you ask me, I'll recommend host failure cluster tolerance equal to 1 or host failure cluster tolerance equal to 2, whatever. That option I will always prefer, because I don't need to worry about anything. Because only the recommendation is all the hosts within the cluster must be of same capacity. That is what the VMware recommendation says. I'll inform the customer saying, if you want to purchase a host, please purchase from one vendor, same capacity and same version of hardware and same CPU architecture, then this HA option will work perfectly for me. So I will always prefer first option. And the last option is dedicated host. Means you are purchasing something, you are spending something, okay, and you are keeping the machine ideal for lifetime. Okay, normally whatever the server that you purchase, you will get it for 3 years warranty. Okay, in 3 years of span, the dedicated failover host doesn't perform any task, means no failure happened in your customer environment since last 3 years. Then whatever the amount that you spend on dedicated failover host, it's go waste because it is doing nothing, just sitting idle to something to happen. Some failure must happen, then I'll come into picture. If something goes wrong, then I'll come into picture. That is not the case, right? So third option, very rarely will use. Second option, third option, I haven't seen anyone using it so far. Second option, I have seen customers are using it if they are keen about their things to be controlled manually. And the first option is commonly used in every customer environment. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. And one more option, define host failover capacity by slot policy. Let me see what Google says about it, because this is the latest option or the new feature that they have introduced in 6.7, I believe, or maybe in 6.5, I haven't seen. Okay. So HA admission control. Policy 6.7. Percentage of resources. Okay. Slot policy. What is this slot policy? Select a slot size policy that covers all powered on VMs or on a fixed size. You can also calculate how many VMs require multiple slots. Okay. Disable. Fine. Dedicated failover host. These are the three options, and host failure cluster tolerance is the another option. So this mostly prefer. Or if you are not using this, one of three options. This I never seen. This I have seen in some customer environments. This option newly introduced, that we have to test it in slot policy. Okay, so let me go to vCenter. vCenter, recalculate. VMs require multiple slots, 0 out of 9. Okay, cover all. Fixed slot size. Fine. Let me go to advanced edit, advanced options, and there's nothing. Okay, you have to define a parameter. Data store heartbeats, it's fine. During the HA session, I have explained. Okay, so host failure responses. Failure response, reboot. I'm just trying to see if there are any missing. VM monitoring only, or disable VM monitoring only, or application monitoring, custom. Monitoring you can enable. Okay, and data store with APD. What is this APD? All paths down, failure response. If all paths down, okay, what action HA should perform? Okay, and if a data store PDL, what is this? So with PDL failure response, issue events. Okay, if something goes wrong on the data store and HA is still monitoring those data stores via FDM agent inside the data store, these are the few options that you can control, as they have introduced in 6.7. VM monitoring, as I said, VMware tools, right? Host isolation response. Don't do any action. If the host is disconnected, please don't try to do anything, just leave it. Fine. But what I'm looking is, I'm looking for HA slots where I can find monitor, VMware HA summary, okay, and 9 machines, running runtime information. Advanced runtime info, not this one. Configure, high availability, edit, admission control, disable. Okay. Host failure cluster tolerance 1. Runtime monitor. Okay. Number of protected VMs 9. And runtime information. Okay. Heartbeat. These two. Configuration issues. Nothing. Data store. Under nothing. So somewhere I should see HA slots where I can find, looking for summary, maybe cluster HA. Which is disabled, host monitoring is enabled, VM monitoring is enabled, and protected VMs and stuff. Fine. But somewhere in the oldest version, you will see slots here. Strange. They have changed the configuration here. Very good. Let me go to configuration and try to find out if there are any other options. Nothing. Whisper. Okay. Admission control policy. There's nothing. Performance degradation, VM isolation 100%. Tolerate values, raise a warning if there is sufficient failure capacity to guarantee same performance after 100%. Warning disabled. Okay. They have slot policy. Calculate the slot size based on maximum CPU memory reservation of overhead. Okay. Let me explain slots in a different way. VMware HA slot size. Okay, in HA, what it is saying, VMware HA, as per VMware, HA slot is a logical representation of memory and CPU resources that satisfy the requirement for any powered on virtual machine in the cluster. Okay, so before we go on calculate all these things, let me take a simple scenario and explain slot. Slot. Okay. How many hosts we have? Hello?
Three
hosts, right? Now I kept some reservation, host failure cluster tolerance equal to 1, right? Now 10 GB is the capacity, for example, 10 GB is the total capacity. Total capacity is 10 GB. Total cluster capacity is 30 GB. One host capacity is 10 GB, 10 divided by 3, which is 3 GB, 3 in reservation, 7 in production, 7 in production, 3 in reservation, 7 in production, 3 in reservation. Understood? Okay. means you have total 21 GB for production or 20 GB for production and 9 GB in HA. Understood? Now I have one VM with 4 GB RAM capacity and I have one VM with 2 GB RAM capacity. Another one 2 GB and 2 GB. Another one 2 GB, 1 GB. This is the configuration and another 2 GB. Fine? You understood?
Yes.
Now, if this host goes down, I have two machines. One machine is 4 GB. It cannot come and restart here, because the reservation is 3 GB. And 2 GB, it can restart here or it can restart here. Doesn't matter for 2 GB machine. Right? Then how it will define or keep the reservation in runtime? Means I'm just giving an example. In real time, you'll see one machine is running with 12 GB RAM, another machine is running with 2 GB RAM, another machine is running with 32 GB RAM. Like that, you'll have an n number of machines, around 1,000 machines in vCenter, and host failure cluster tolerance equal to 1. You never know which host will go down. And if the host is goes down, and there is one big VM, that VM should restart somewhere. How it will make sure we have a adequate space and all within a 5 minutes, because for restart it will take around 5 minutes, right? Okay, so slots, what slots will do? It is difficult to calculate the reservation like this. Okay, what happens, it will create everything as one single floor. Let's take your floor. When you are calculating something, what you will do? When you are calculating something, what you will do if you are attaching tiles to your floor? Okay, you go to market and you will calculate the size. Okay, for this size tile, I need these many. Right? For this size, I need 30 tiles. If I'm talking about small size tiles, I need 24. If a medium size, I need 30, 20, 60, like that, right? Number of tiles will vary based on the size, because your room size is this much only. Okay, now you want to fit different size of the tiles. What you will do? One smaller one, one bigger one. You'll go mad, because filling the gaps is very difficult. Agree or disagree? I'm talking about simple floor tiles. Similarly, if you look at a VMware cluster running with 10 hosts and all the 10 hosts are running with 100, some hundreds of VMs. Okay, every machine has a different size. Okay, keeping the reservations is very difficult. So what system will do? There is an algorithm which is running on backend. Based on the number of powered on VMs, it will define the slot size. Okay, so calculating everything, it will come up with the best practice one slot. Okay, so this slot size will be in such a way, it's a combination of CPU and RAM, by the way. Okay, so the slot size will be in such a way, even if a bigger host goes down or a smaller host goes down, you no need to do much calculation, because slots, based on the slot size, system will allow you to place the VMs. In the sense, three hosts are there. Okay, one VM is running, one big VM is running, another big VM is running. slow. While calculating the slots, it will create some slot sizes. Make sure it will not allow you to create one more big VM here, because if this host or this host goes wrong, one of these big VM we should support here. So it will keep little extra reservation here based on the slot, so that you no need to do manual work. It will automatically, big VM will come and restart here, and small VM go to other VM, other host and restart. This is where the slotting concept will be used on the back end. You will not do anything, by the way, you will not calculate anything, but everything will be taken care by VMware HA. Understood? Or any confusion? No? Yes? Most of these are theory concepts. You will not see any lab scenarios, or you don't need to do anything over here. System is taking care of everything. What you will do? Just enable HA and sit relaxly. Clear? Understood?
Yes.
Any confusion?
Yes.
Guys, come on. Vivek is there or he's left?
Yes.
Understood?
Yes, yes, I'm left.
Okay, so these are the few options. One option we left is HA reservation based on the, HA admission control policy based on the what we call it as slot size that we haven't tested. Explained properly, but rest of the things are covered. 6.7 has got that new feature that I never implemented earlier. Okay, so let me stop here.